Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Holiday Pops, with the oldest continuously performing volunteer orchestra in America, your Melrose Symphony Orchestra! Under the musical direction of our maestro, celebrating his 25th year, Yoichi Unagawa! At this time, we ask that you please silence all electronic devices for the duration of the performance. We remind you that audio and video recording is strictly prohibited, and we ask that you refrain from taking any flash photographs, as it is distracting to the musicians and will immediately get you an entry on the naughty list. For your safety, please take a moment to familiarize yourselves with the exits at all four corners of the auditorium. In the event of an emergency, please walk, do not run, to the nearest exit. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm winter's welcome to our chief toy maker and president of Melrose Symphony, Kathy Radley.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays to all of you. We're so happy to have you all here with us. So we have many organizations that do help us an awful lot with bringing these concerts to you. And one is the Melrose Cooperative Bank Foundation. It's a legacy of the bank, and they continue to support us and be sponsors for the whole concert season. So we thank the Melrose Cooperative Bank Foundation. And tonight's featured performer is soloist David Thorne Scott and Lydia Harrell are sponsored by Brad Hutchinson Real Estate. And so we thank Mark, Brad, and all the folks. And Bobby Sees is our caterer this evening. And we have two intermissions, and so please go upstairs and see what they have to offer. Also, while you're upstairs, the Symphony Shop is open once again, and we have new items. We have fabulous wine glasses that say MSO. We have aprons, new aprons, and we have some children's musical books, among other things, so check it out. And we also want to thank, of course, you, our fabulous orchestra. You come to all our concerts, you support us financially. Many have made donations, and we are so appreciative, so thank you. And our musicians. They come here every Monday night to rehearse. They play their hearts out to give us wonderful music, and we thank them for their time and their talent. Enjoy the concert. Thank you.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Happy
Hanukkah. Happy holidays. Are you guys ready for some great music?
Thank you.
going. I don't know about you. It's a very exciting piece. And conducting it is a blast, I might add. Now we're going to play some music from Polar Express. It's got some beautiful tunes in it, and some places where it's chugging along. And anyway, here we go.
Thank you.
called Bugler's Holiday. And it's a holiday for everyone except for the buglers. Because there's a lot of notes in it. A big hand for our trumpet section. Come on out, guys. Rolling across the bottom of the lake and onto the green. All right. Jesus and the gentleman are very, very impressed. So Jesus gets up and he takes his first shot. Jesus' shot is even faster, right? Heading down the fairway, also for the water feature, and then just as it gets to the water, it just kind of walks right across it. It's up on the green, very close to the hole. Right? So it's this gentleman's turn to go, and so he gets ready. He whacks the ball, but it goes all the way off to the left at quite a good speed and bounces off a tree, goes across the fairway, hits another tree, and is about to land in the middle of it. All of a sudden, an eagle comes swooping down, grabs the ball in midair, and goes higher and higher and higher. And it comes diving back down towards the green. And just as it gets right over the hole, it goes... And Moses turns to Jesus and says, "It's really tough to play golf with your dad."
sniffing at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by choir. Folks dressed up like Eskimos.
Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe.
Santa's on his way. He's got lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh.
And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly.
So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Santa's on his way. He's loading lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. Every child will spy to see a reindeer and know how to fly.
And so we're offering this simple to kids from 1 to 92.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry
cold. We were going for sort of a South American version of a Christmas song with sort of like a Brazilian bossa nova feel. And that's specifically for any of you Brazil fans that lost their World Cup games. That was tough. But now we're going to actually do more of a New England-y kind of song. Actually, I wrote this one originally on a slushy winter day, kind of like a November, you know, where it's not really cold enough to be pretty yet, and my windshield wipers were swiping the slush away. And it, after a while, got to sort of this hypnotic kind of swing rhythm, and I was thinking to myself, but soon it's gonna snow. So that's the name of this next song.
When you see a Christmas tree or hear that north wind blow, set a spell, cause you can tell that soon it's gonna snow. Me, oh my, you just gotta try to catch old winter's show. Frosty air is everywhere and soon it's gonna snow. Walk down the lane when white is on your window pane. You'd better wear warm clothes when Jack Frost is nipping at your nose. So keep it warm, enjoy the storm, but drink that eggnog slow. Sing a song, it won't be long till we're all laying low. soon it's gonna snow. Or hear that north wind blow, just set a spell, cause you can tell that soon it's gonna snow. Me, oh my, you just gotta try to catch all the winter show. Frosty air is everywhere, and soon it's gonna snow. Walk down the lane when white is on your window pane. You better wear warm clothes when Jack Frost is nipping at your nose. Keep it warm, enjoy the storm, but drink that eggnog slow. Sing a song, it won't be long till we're all laying low. Soon it's gonna snow, soon it's gonna snow. White stuff will fall around everywhere. Ice cubes will form right in your hair. Bring your long underwear, it's gonna snow. Whoa, 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 whoa. It's gonna snow. I also said that was a nice dress. I think I was the first to say that.
Yes, you were.
All right, we got a little take people to church now, right?
It's time. It was time a while ago, but now is the time.
Now it's really time.
Yeah.
We're gonna go tell it on the mount.
Bye.
So David's not going far. He's just going to the piano to play for me on this next song. It was written by some friends of mine, Jeff Megan and David Tobin. They actually won a Daytime Emmy for a song that I sang on as well, but this one isn't the one. But it's a good one, I promise. It's called The Holidays Are a Precious Time. Featured, and they it actually, there were no lines over it or anything. You know how usually you hear a little piece and then suddenly they're talking. That's not what this was. You heard the whole song, and it was very emotional, and I'm very honored to have been the singer on it.
So you were basically in The Young and the Restless.
Yeah, I was in The Young and the Restless.
So we got a little medley for you now. So, Lydia, I don't know what you think, but I feel like the more songs I learn, the more opportunity I have to screw them up. Because, I don't know, do you ever do this where I'll sing the verse of one song and then I'll accidentally switch to the bridge of a different one?
Yes.
That ever happened to you?
Yeah. Yep. Or I just start making up stuff because I don't know what I was singing.
Yeah.
So, this sounds right.
Yeah, so two Christmas songs, Let Us Know, Let Us Know, Let Us Know, and Winter Wonderland. I would always make this mistake. I would sing the beginning of the other one of these songs, and then I would switch to the bridge. So for this arrangement we're going to do, which I think is our last one before we're going to take a little intermission, we thought we'd just do everything we can to confuse you so you're just as confused as I am. You'll see what I mean.
It's just fun.
It will be. Since we've no place to go,
let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Well, it doesn't show signs of stopping. I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Kiss goodnight.
Thank you.
So we're going to end the concert with our annual sing-along. We haven't done that in a while since COVID. So I'm going to ask that the lights come on. Yeah, perfect, perfect. I want you to do your best impression of our guests here. And here we go.
Thank you. You can't turn your computer on or off. It's acting up, running slow, opening pages you didn't click, displaying pop-ups constantly. There's a good chance your computer's been hacked or infected with a virus and needs your help. Stop shopping, banking, and entering passwords online until your computer is cleaned and restored. It's inconvenient to be sure, but it's a necessary step to prevent the situation going from bad to worse, from hacked to horrible. Update your security software. Install a new version from a reputable company. You can use your phone or another computer to check reviews of security software. Tech blogs and retail sites usually post them. Choose carefully. Scammers sometimes advertise security software that's malware in disguise. Make your decision. Get back online and download the software. If the security software finds malware, it flags it for you. Delete the suspicious files and restart your computer. If you're still having problems, contact your computer manufacturer or other tech support and find out what else you can do. Once your computer is back to normal, change the passwords you've been using for your bank accounts, your email accounts, and all your other important accounts. The safest route is to choose and use passwords that have upper and lowercase letters, as well as numbers and symbols. And finally, make sure your operating system and internet browser are set to update automatically. You want to keep your computer operating at peak performance. Visit OnGuardOnline.gov to learn more.
Scam artists are pretending to be IRS officials to get your money. They'll call, email, or text you, claiming you owe back taxes or there's a problem with your tax return. They even rig caller ID to make the call look official. They play on your fears. They threaten to take your driver's license or sue, arrest, or deport you. They want you to pay fast. What's the truth? The truth is the IRS's first contact with you will always be a letter in the mail. It's not a phone call, email, or text message. They won't insist that you pay with a prepaid debit card, a wire transfer, or cashier's check. Now you know. Has an IRS imposter contacted you? Report it at ftc.gov/imposters.
You can only be sure that a network uses effective encryption if it asks you to provide a WPA or WPA2 password. If you aren't sure, it's best to assume the network is not secure. The second way to protect your information is to send it through a secure website. A secure site will encrypt your information, even if the network doesn't. If the web address starts with HTTPS, then your information is encrypted before it's sent. The S stands for secure. Look for HTTPS on every page you visit, not just when you log in. If you use an unsecured Wi-Fi network to log into an unencrypted website, strangers using that network can hijack your account and steal your private documents, contacts, family photos, even your username and password. If that happens, an imposter could use your email or social networking account to pretend to be you and scam people you care about. Or a hacker could use your password from one website to try to log into a different account and access your personal or financial information. Here are some steps you can take to protect yourself when you use a public Wi-Fi hotspot. Only log in or enter personal information on secure sites that use encryption. Again, look for a web address that begins with HTTPS. Don't use the same username and password for different sites. It could give someone who gains access to one of your accounts access to many of your accounts. Never email financial information, including credit card, social security, and checking account numbers, even if the network and website are secure. Don't stay permanently signed in to accounts. When you've finished using a site, log out. The bottom line, secure Wi-Fi hotspots require a password. Secure websites start with HTTPS. Remember, it's easy to find trusted information about computer security. Just visit OnGuardOnline.gov, the federal government site to help you be safe, secure, and responsible online.